Hello everyone, this is Crota giving you a shoutcast between Showtime and Dayfly here on Scrap Station. Excited to give you this match in particular. I contacted some people from the Prime Clan and I asked if they could give me any new replays. They said no, we couldn't give you any new replays just because of the upcoming GSL, and they're all trying to practice new strategies with the 1.1 patch. But they did decide to give me some of their 1.03 games. So here we have Dayfly Prime spawning over here as the blue Protoss player at the 3 o'clock position. Meanwhile, we have Showtime spawning over here as the red Terran. So Terran versus Protoss here on Scrap Station should be an interesting game, as now we just see that supply depot being placed down. It is a 9 supply depot instead of a 10 supply depot, so that will hurt the economy just a little bit. Not exactly sure what Showtime is going for in this particular matchup. Back over here, we do see Dayfly now finishing off this pylon here. We'll be able to continue to chrono boost and get more and more units out. It looks like that pylon was an 8 pylon just because of the timing on that probe. You normally cannot chrono boost until after your pylon is done, so nicely done by both sides. Showtime now continuing to just train up more and more units. Perhaps we'll throw down a 15 racks in just a moment. There we go. And now this game is underway as we also have a 15 gateway. So it doesn't look like there's going to be any sort of forge play or any sort of cheese on this map so far. Just pretty standard play. A refinery being placed down over here. Most likely, refinery being placed down by Showtime, and assimilator being placed down by Dayfly. As we finally see a probe now moving out in order to gain some sight, making sure that there isn't sort of any sort of proxy barracks outside his base, and then perhaps we'll be doing some scouting as well. So yeah, just looking around, making sure that there is no proxy racks, and now going to go ahead and scout out and see that it is going to be pretty standard play. Showtime, however, not looking to build an orbital command. Oh, there we are. We'll be building an orbital command there, and now perhaps going to train a marine, or is he going to throw a tech lab down? No, it is going to be a marine instead of a tech lab. So one marine to try to deal with this very early probe, or this early probe scouting coming in. However, that probe will not be able to get too much sight, as by that time that probe gets in, this marine should be out in just a moment. There we go. As that probe now looking around on the inside of the space, trying to make sure that there's nothing there, and now in comes a pylon. So that marine does quickly see that there is a pylon there, and that probe really needs to be careful. Down to 15 hit points, may get taken down, as now we see a reactor being thrown down here. So this probe over here may be able to escape just ever so barely. However, that marine cutting through that mineral patch and able to gain sight. However, this pylon over here will be completed. And now, and whether or not that's going to be a mistake, because Showtime does know about this pylon that's being warped in, so he needs to go over there and perhaps start to shoot it down. I do not expect any sort of warp gate research to be up anytime soon, so this pylon will get shot down by this one marine. Production-wise, we do see two additional marines now being trained out from this reactor, and also at this factory. We're currently trying to build up this factory over here. Not quite sure why Dayfly did not cancel this pylon, so that's just going to be a loss of 100 minerals and will be a pretty heavy hit. Dayfly looking to open up with some sort of 3-gate into a 4-gate strategy, 4-gate push. So we may see a proxy pylon perhaps placed somewhere around here or into this location as well, as these units now move out together. We now see another pylon being placed down by Dayfly. Dayfly realizing that he is going to be supply locked and for quite some time, and as this warp gate research is nearing completion, we are getting one stalker out now, as a group of marines now moving out to make sure that there is no proxy pylon out over here, and now trying to take down these rocks. I don't know if I agree with trying to take down these rocks, as these rocks are one of your natural ways to protect yourself from the Protoss players' really, really strong army. It doesn't look like there's going to be any sort of marauders anytime soon, as Showtime now going for the 1-1-1 build with that starport. One stalker now moving around that corner, activating that Zonaga watchtower. More marines trying to take down these rocks. Rocks do have 3 armor, so these marines are only essentially dealing 3 damage per attack here, so that is very, very limited. One stalker now perhaps does not want to engage against these marines, trying to get within that range, and now going to go ahead and pull back there. One marine down to, 5 hit points, and now trying to just use these shields very, very effectively, and that range of 6 versus that range of 5 on those marines. We see a Nexus now being thrown down by Dayfly, so Dayfly going into a 2 or a 3 gate and then deciding to expand instead of pushing. That's a little bit of a strange maneuver, as he has a lot of production building. So Dayfly now moving back with the stalker, not exactly sure what he wants to do. He does have a couple sentries down over here, but that will not be enough to hold off any Marines that try to walk up this ramp, especially now that we also have a starport. So that starport will start training more and more units here. And I think, I'm not 100% sure, but I think there's not enough room for a building to land right here. So that's a little bit of a mistake there. Yeah, so he's unable to really land here, and that's just a horrible mistake. I don't know exactly what he was thinking, as this reactor is a very, very expensive building to build, 50 units of time, and now being forced to build another reactor. Yeah, so I can't read Korean, but I'm pretty sure that he just talked about how big of a mistake he made by denying himself this building of this reactor. We do see Marines now dropping into this base over here. Zealots now trying to come out as well. However, the sentry could have dropped down a force field to try to deny any sort of pickup, as another stalker being warped in here. Army-wise, we see 900 versus 850 new Showtime, however, sitting on a lot less harvesters, only sitting on 24 harvesters compared to 31, and Showtime no longer training any additional SCVs. Back over here, we now see a Banshee joining in on this fight as well. One Banshee being trained. We do not see any cloaking research, however. So we do see the stim pack now being researched, perhaps that combat shield as well, quickly doing a scanner sweep to reveal any sort of any observers. However, I don't think there was an observer in that base just quite yet, unless I missed it. I'm going to be too difficult to try to see if there's any kills on any of these Marines, as this medevac now moving out with this Hellion as well. So Hellion, Marine, and Marauder going to try to take down these rocks over here. We do have Dayfly Prime now mining from two bases with a significant economic lead, 36 harvesters compared to 24, and mining from an additional 8 mineral patches for this 3-gate with a robotics facility. However, unless he starts producing more and more units, he's not going to be able to handle this army that's currently coming in. Banshee, Medevac, Marines, Marauders, very, very strong, especially with Stimpak already being researched, Combat Shield, and the Infernal Pre-Igniter now being researched as well. The Combat Shield does not take that long to research, and the Infernal Pre-Igniter is already nearing completion. So we do see Stalker is now going to go ahead and wait off over here. As these units now pushing through, we have one observer. So the observer does see that these rocks are going to get taken down. And now Showtime going to just walk in with these very, very strong units. That one observer sitting there gaining sight, perhaps trying to hide in the brush over here. Stalker's now coming out to engage. Will it be enough? No, those observers, that observer just staying in position, and these stalkers and sentries just gathering over here to try to do a little bit of a push, as another observer now sitting outside the space here. Production-wise, we do see more Banshees, no cloaking research, and now SCVs joining in on the fight. So these SCVs are going to try to act as a meat shield against this incoming attack, and will it be enough is the question. Those SCVs do have 45 hit points, and those stalkers are trying to engage there. So Stalker is now going to go ahead and engage. A quick scanner sweep revealing medevac accidentally picking up a unit here. Units fighting back and forth. A nice use of force field blocking a lot of these units, and now Guardian Shield as well. So that Guardian Shield giving an additional 2 armor against all of these range units here. Zealots fighting their way through both sides, taking a lot of casualties. However, those force fields now going to be depleted, as SCVs pulling off the mineral line and doing some sort of all-in attack. Probes now coming off the mineral line as well. More Stalkers and Zealots now joining in. One Banshee in the air just trying to rack up that damage as well. Marines, Marauders, and Hellions with the Infernal Pre-Igniter able to rip through a lot of these probes, and this is going to be a problem as more and more units are going to get taken down by Dayfly. Dayfly losing this war of attrition, now down to a 225 mineral army, and that is going to be it. Not much can be done, as this expansion over here no longer going to be able to be mined. We do see some Stalkers over here, and now mass Marines, Marauders with SCVs going to perhaps try to push into this location, going after these probes. Stalkers trying to engage. However, the one medevac in the air healing a lot of these units, and Dayfly will not be able to push back this attack, losing another one of those Stalkers trying to push back even further. Dayfly does have and is able to warp in more units. However, he knows that the game is over, and I believe he says GG. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. I hope you guys enjoyed this 1v1 replay between Showtime and Dayfly here on Scrap Station. So Showtime really at the end doing an all-in push, taking all of his SCVs off the mineral line in order to absorb some of that damage. Because the SCVs are using that attack move command, those Stalkers and those Zealots will naturally try to attack some of those SCVs as well, allowing those Marines and those Marauders to just constantly shoot and deal more damage, especially with that medevac support. So the medevac and that Banshee, the one with that high DPS, able to deal 24 damage every 1.25 seconds, is very, very fast. And the fact that these Banshees are able to deal a lot of damage towards those Zealots, and those Marauders and those Marines have a little bit of a harder time with those Zealots. However, those Banshees able to deplete those shields and deal enough damage to those units very quickly. Thanks for watching again. Thanks for listening. And if you have not already, please like this video. Hope to see you guys on Battle.net.